functions and directions and nuisances. Whereas in a theater, the doors are locked, there will be only focus light, that is the light of the image in the screen by the projector. It is known as focused view. Like that environment, why we are creating environment? Because we are not so mature to create our environment, because of which environment is created for us. So that is environmental projection or promotion. One is innate, second thing is environmental, third thing is coherent. If 10 people they are doing yoga, yogasana, immediately I can sit with them and do that yogasana. Because that is a coherent stimulus. I am having that proper methodological pursuit of learning yoga, that is innate. I am entering into a yoga class where everything is exclusively meant for that yoga teaching and training and learning. So immediately I get that thing. That is known as environmental stimulus. 10 people are doing, 10 people are learning the same thing. I am also beginning to learn the same thing. That is coherent stimulus. I am seeing lot of books, I am seeing lot of materials which promote me, which gives the benefits of yoga. I am tempted to do that yoga. That is known as inducing stimulus. Fifth thing is provocative stimulus. There is an acharya, there is a master who is compassionate, considerate and co-potential. That person out of his provincial mercy, he makes us to learn things. That is a provocative stimulus. These five stimulus are very much essential for a person to be molded. It is known as panchagati or upaya panchaka as per the shastras. How to organize knowledge? I gave a very great challenge in Jawaharlal Nehru Technical University. I told that if six students are entrusted to me for 6 months, within the 6 months, they will be completing MBBS or BTEC. And after 6 months, initially at the time of admission, there will be a report for their EDSE to certify that they are EDS. The eligibility that I wanted from them is 10 standard fail. So after 6 months, continuously monthly, the progress report will be evaluated by these people. After 6 months, amidst the media people, international or national peers, these people, without their reference, even which the normal streamlined people, they could not do, that will be done by these people without any reference, deference, only with reference to the knowledge that they have possessed. They don't need any biblic reference. They don't need any hint or summarized recognition. They need only the reverence by which they learned the vidya, that vidya or the translator or the supporter. I have called that and I hope that Rishi Prabhakar is very much interested. He is going to supply few students for this process. Then I am asked how I am going to do that, and it is very surprising that how I am going to do this 6 months of special accelerated training for 5 years of course. The course is for 5 years. And they told that it is surprising how I am going to complete it in 6 months. Then I told that it is indeed more surprising to learn that this 6 months of learning is tracked for 5 years. And this is without any philosophical indoctrination. It is without any religious compulsion. If the person is interested in mantra or upasana, that is something optional. That is not obligatory. Only that is what I want to say. Organizing wisdom. See, if you just make this as a mess, nobody can sit here. But if you organize with the space mechanics, how to manage things in wardrobes, how to make the things in upper drawers, how to make things in inner shelves. If you manage everything, it can accommodate more people. Like that, unorganized stuff that occupies more space. I also told in emotional physics, a lecture on emotional physics, I told that if you are scolding a person with unlimited wrath for just 3 minutes, the amount of energy exhausted by you unnecessarily, unduly, unlawfully is equal to that of the knowledge required for mastering Bhagavad Gita. So, and wrong things, doing wrong things in the right manner and doing right things in the wrong manner, that occupies more space in the brain. And it is known as organizing the brain. How to organize our brain? It is known as there are 5 steps. One is how to organize the space, how to organize the depth, and how to structure the knowledge, how to restructure whenever required, and how to make it flow. So how to get this space? For example, if this book is there, it should be having the sub unit of 20 units. But if it is not intentionally learned by means of a good process, if it is not methodologically understood, it will occupy a very big. For example, you know that if a yogi comes and sits in a chair, two yogis can sit in my chair. Whereas if a bhogi comes and sits, he requires two more chairs. So, knowledge that is well seasoned, knowledge that is well processed, they are converted into subtleties. For example, if you carry 100 crores of rupees or 1 crore of rupees in the form of coins, it may take a huge bag. If you are carrying sand or cotton, then you have 1 crore, it may take a lot of tracks. Convert it into gold, you can take a big suitcase. Convert it into diamonds, you can carry it in your pocket. So it is the subtlety management. Whatever you learn it wholeheartedly and understand the base for it. I am telling this to a concourse now, but still, unless I take a syllabus or a particular lesson, and unless I practically teach how to convert into subtlety, it cannot be understood at all. If anything is understood with an ontological and teleological basis, that is the fundamental studies, then that becomes small, sharp, shrewd, and very much essential, soliciting more occupation. How to occupy space, how to occupy depth, more depth, how we can organize in our minds, and how to structure, because we have to bring it in the form of structure. And whenever something erodes that or overrules that, how to restructure and how to make it flow. There are three types of flow. One is a fountain flow, second is a fluent flow, third is a facile flow. If you are writing or demonstration, that is a facile flow. If you want to talk, that is a fluent flow. But thought should be in the form of fountain. So a fountain flow of thoughts and a fluent flow of your speeches, as well as a facile flow of your demonstration in the form of scripts or experiments, that is required for the skill of flow. Because whenever you do something, three things should triangularly reach with each other. What are they? You should be well-versed in the concept. You should be well-versed in the language. You should be well-versed in the order of presentation of both. Grammatical order of the language, as well as the sequential order of the contents of the subject. Both of the things must be simultaneously present apart from language and concept flow. So this thing is a great divine skill. We consider everything as divine, but most of our worships are not meant, are not tuned for knowledge development. They are there, most of our existing things are there to cover or to justify our mistakes, illiteracy, idiocy and impotence. So God has given innumerable things. That is why if a person, even with knowledge, if a person is not manageable, if the person is not managing, he will cry with knowledge, he will cry with wealth, he will struggle with the syllabus, and he will fight with the society. That is the fate of that person who has no mastery in the real sense as the Shastras they have enumerated. So that is the problem with these people. So it is known as organization. And the second thing is activity. What are the activities of knowledge? One is acquisition, second is mobilization, third is management, fourth thing is retrieval, fifth thing is distribution or sharing or transfer. So these things are to be specially managed. So that's what I told in the previous seminar, it is resha prapti. When you see the tail or the tip of the tail of something which creates some interest, you will go further. After hearing from me, you have to start hearing from lot of people, learning from lot of people. It should be systematized in the form of syllabus. It should be practiced for at least 10 years and taught to your generations. That is the ultimate purpose. And all of these various methodologies in the form of symposia, in the form of lecture, seminar and various other things are just to kindle your enthusiasm to announce that there is some reality with which you are maintaining some distance very honorably. So these five activities are there. There are few activity theories also. Activity thing is known as human-computer interrelation theory. As human beings, they have lost their innate biopsycho-neuro-computational ability. They have to be dependent on computers. But computer dependence itself, that should be in such a manner that it should not erode the computation skill of a person, I have already told. It should be an interim thing, it should be a starter, it should be a supportive element, it should not be a